started out this season with singular goals, to make it to the NCAA tournament. Dick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Boise State Broncos.
It's showtime, baby. Let's get the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Broncos know they're in for a fight tonight, Dick. What are their keys to succeed this evening?
Hey, if you ask me, the keys are simple, Brad. Number one, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second, get the ball inside for the high percentage shot. That'll open up the outside game as well. Thirdly, don't let turnovers decide the game. Protect the ball. Take care of the basketball.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Fakes a jumper, turnaround jumper. Can't get the shot to go. The point guard takes the feed. Both teams are looking to get something going here. The center with the ball. Trying to pack it inside.
Nice fake.
The small forward takes the pass. For the bucket, perfectly executed. He keeps the dribble as they reset. He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
Hey, defenders must be confident. We're going for a steal. If not, it'll often end up with a personal foul.
Picked off. Trying to draw some contact. Knocks it down. The power forward gets the pass. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
The power forward gets the ball. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, field the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
I think they're trying to make a statement.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Doesn't miss that opportunity either. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block, puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
The Broncos have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. A little bit of a collision there, but no foul call, Dick.
I tell you, good call by the official. Not blowing a whistle. I think it's an excellent call. The crowd will be on cloud nine if they can put some points up on the board.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Inside, on the inside, for two, and off the mark. The ball goes out of play. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
There's a high screen. Nice shot. Fed the low block. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Looking for a good shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Just your excitement with that jam. Two for one opportunity.
A high screen. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They're going to move it around the perimeter. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it. Up and inside.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure into basketball.
He can't get the bucket to fall. At halftime, the Broncos are ahead by two. Too many times in that.
They certainly did, Brad. I've said it a million times. Turnovers kill momentum. I don't see a lot of these kids taking my advice out there.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches. Yeah, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Inside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
And he'll kick it back outside. He looks for the bomb. Rims out. And the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Kicks it out. Kicked out from down low. Picks off the lazy pass.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Count the bucket and the foul.
He made a statement on that play, baby. I ain't backing down, is his cry. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
No finish on that one. Power forward with the ball. He up fakes. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Way off target. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. 5 second call approaching. picked off. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
And he'll kick it back outside. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a pass.
Launches the three.
Boy, you gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picked out of the air. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there.
Dick, you gotta love tournament games like this. Great first half. Second half's been more of the same, and I don't know. What do you think? The favorite, can he pull it out or not?
Hey, Brad, I think this is going right to the finish line with the last possession. Whoever gets the ball last, I think, is going to win this baby. I mean, they're making every big shot, both these clubs.
He'll regroup the offense. Defense giving some room. He shoots from right of the circle. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Aaron's right about that. Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
Go back in front by two. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
And we're back to a two-point game. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Danielson is fired up right now emotionally.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
He gets the rejection, and the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
The lead is down to a bucket.
Hey, this place is about to explode. It's dynamite, baby.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Great recovery after the rebound.
That's how you stop the fast break. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Scorches the net. Ready to start again. And the fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
The ball goes out of play. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
The point guard handles the pass. Arm and foul. There's is a turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
First shot is good. Makes the second shot. Misses his third.
T.O. called. Hey, we got a barn burner here, baby. I'm thinking last second shot for the win, Mr. Nestler.
We're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
He tries to beat the buzzer. Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Marquette is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.